Jest z nami Oli Thompson, bardzo szczęśliwy Oli Thompson po walce z Kamilem Walusiem. I just said you are very happy and you seem like this. So yeah. How much happy are you?
Yeah, I'm real happy. You know, if you see me smile, you know it's for a good reason, because I don't really smile very much. You know, I'm just working hard and looking like this. So I'm gonna enjoy tonight, go home tomorrow and train on Monday. Just be my normal self again.
You know you speak fast, so you can be sure I will make it on slow-mo after I'm gonna render and upload it on YouTube.
I'm gonna do the rest of this interview really slow and nice, because this is how I can talk if I try really hard. And this is how my mom wants me to talk.
Thank you very much.
No, I
get it. You can be fast. The same as the fight.
No, I need to talk slow. My mom keeps telling me, talk slow, and I forget when I'm excited and happy.
So maybe you're the ADHD?
Yeah, mate, ADHD for speech.
Yeah, for speech.
My body stops though. My body relaxes, but my mouth keeps moving.
But you know, there's a bit of ADHD during the fight, because it seems like you were in the rush. You just bull rushed him. You took him down, and you know.
I watched them some old great Mike Tyson clips in my relaxing time for the fight, and I love the way Mike used to. The bell go, and he'd jog over to the other guy, to the guy's corner. Just show that determination and the eagerness, you know. So I thought to myself, you know, I'm gonna jog over to his corner and go and get him. And it's a good feeling. You go and close him off and just get stuck in.
And after you took him down, you were in a half guard. So it's usually a very good position. Did you knew once you will be in this position, it's gonna be a very difficult moment for him.
Yeah, I mean, if you've watched some of my fights, half guard is my favorite. You know, with big guys, especially when you're big, sweaty and slippery, sometimes side control is very easy to escape, because you just move away and slide. The half guard, you use the legs to keep him in almost.
He just locks himself in.
Yeah.
A bit.
Yeah. So I passed a few times, went to a few north souths, but it was too slippery. It's really hard to get hold of anything in there. So I just stayed on top and we softened him up, took my time, and just being patient, because I know. You can be tough and take them shots for a certain amount of time, but after a while it kind of sucks your energy out. You know, working the body, the legs, the face. And near the end of the fight, I just saw a change, and it kind of broke his will a little bit maybe, and just started firing more shots down. And you know, I got a good gas tank, so I can fight at that pace for as long as necessary.
Yeah, and he was actually breathing heavy right at the beginning of the second round. Did you notice this?
I didn't really notice the breathing, but I noticed the body language was slowing down a little bit. His frustration kicks in. You know, a big guy on top of you hitting you. I'm not that big at the moment, but fairly big, and I can make myself very heavy when I need to. You know, in grappling, it's not how much you weigh on the scales, it's how heavy you make yourself and how you position your body. So I'm pretty happy with how I did today, and I think my grappling coach back home will be happy with me.
But not taking away anything from Kamil, who was a huge underdog, but his hips movement on the ground, on his back, was very good. And he did even the Superman punch, so I was surprised how surprised you were.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Kamil's a young guy, he's hungry. And this was a big opportunity for him to get a win against a guy who people kind of recognize as someone who's done quite well. But sometimes you take the step up and you seize it and you jump up. Sometimes you take it and it doesn't quite come off. And he has to go back and do his thing, train hard and come back again. I'm sure he'll do really well.
I know probably, how many interviews did you do today?
Maybe 20.
But after the fight?
No, after the fight maybe 8.
Okay, so I guess everyone asked you about the Mariusz Pudzianowski fight?
Yeah, just the last few.
I will try to make it even more interesting.
Okay.
You know, because you said before, he was better strongman, so it would be a great motivation to show him you're a better fighter.
For sure, I know. I mean, I wasn't in the same category as him in strongman, you know. I'd done well in my own level, like British title and 8th in the world championships. But Pudzianowski was one of, or the greatest in the top two, along with Zdrina Savickas, and two are the best ever. So he revolutionized the game. So I wouldn't try and claim that we were necessarily rivals in strongman. I was trying to get the top 10, and he was trying to win. But this is a different sport. But it's an interesting background to make a fight. He's still developing his game, working on it, and that's fine. But if he's called me out, that's great. You know, like I say, let's get it done, because I want to get back here as soon as possible.
Last quick one, very quick one. Who's holding the paycheck, you or your wife?
you know, it's not me. It's not me. I don't want the paycheck. I don't come here for the paycheck. But I hand it over.
But it helps.
And my life becomes a lot better when I do.
Yeah.
And it's Christmas time.
Of course.
So we've been struggling for a few months now. So this is a good result to take home with me. And I'm going to go and enjoy some free drinks tonight.
Good luck with your fat, hopefully, paycheck.
Thank you. It's always a bonus to make some money.
Thank you.
Thanks, man. With pleasure.
Great.